A car hire company uses a database table, Tred, to store the details of the cars. The table has fields to represent each car's license number, mileage, and the tread depth of each of its four tires. Question A says, suggest suitable names for each of the fields described. This question requires us to take this paragraph and find names for six fields that are mentioned. Let's read through the paragraph again and underline any potential field names. Remember, another name for a field is an attribute. The table has fields to represent each car's license number. That is a potential field. Mileage is a potential field. And the tread depth is a potential field. They mentioned that the tread depth is stored for each of the four tires, meaning we could have a separate field for each of these four fields. This would make up 4, 5, 6 fields, and that should complete our question. Let's go ahead and make up some field names. Whenever we're making field names, we generally want them to be one word that is not too long to write out. Certain words can be abbreviated, such as number. We can abbreviate that to NO. So license number, the field name for that could be license NO. If we're joining two words together, we usually put a capital letter to represent that this is the next word. So you can see that N is capitalized in license NO. The next one we have is mileage. This can be used as a field name, as is. Remember to capitalize the first letter. We then have four different tread depths for each of the tires. The field names tire 1, tire 2, tire 3, and tire 4 are not descriptive enough for our database table. Tire 1 does not specify which specific wheel we're speaking about. We would have to store a separate key to tell the user which tire tire 1 corresponds to. Instead, it may be better to categorize them by two attributes, whether they're on the front of the car or the back of the car, and whether they're on the left or the right. So we can write labels as such. The front left tire could be FL. The front right tire could be FR, the back right tire could be BR, and the back left tire could be BL. Let's now form our field name. We could begin with tire. Then we could mention the position of the tire. Let's start with FL. We could then abbreviate tread depth to simply TD. There's quite a few ways of structuring this field name. The examiner is quite lenient, and you usually won't get marked down if you have a different approach. Let's go ahead and write these in our answer. The first one for the front left tire, the second for the front right tire, then for the back left tire, and finally the back right tire.